From the tip of Malin Head to the safe haven of Kinsale, Ireland's Wild Atlantic Way is a sensational journey.
With 2020 the year of the staycation, I've headed to Kinsale in West Cork as part of Fáilte Ireland's Make a Break for It campaign. And of course, one of the best things about a staycation is that all of this is within driving distance from wherever you live.
You're half the world away. You're half the world away.
Originally a medieval fishing port, historic Kinsale is one of the most picturesque, popular and historic towns on the southwest coast of Ireland.
Just 25 kilometres from Cork City, Kinsale is simply beautiful. From its long waterfront and yacht-filled harbour to the colourful, narrow winding streets, it's got charm in bucket loads.
It's really great to see so many staycators coming into Kinsale, especially in the last couple of weeks since sort of the restaurants, the hotels, cafes have been opened. Kinsale is a safe place. There is space, you know, certain hotels, restaurants, you're checking your temperature as you walk in. So hopefully people will be reassured when they come into Kinsale. Being sort of a sailing town predominantly, there's amazing sort of water sport activities. There's gorgeous walks, so there's a silly walk towards Charles Fort. There's history walking tours as well, so we do have a lot of activities on offer. Kinsale is known for the foodie aspect of the town, and we've got some amazing gourmet restaurants. In 2018, we won Ireland's Best Foodie Town Award, so it's a real honour to have that. We're the start or the end of the Wild Atlantic Way, so it's a great spot to come spend a couple of nights here, experience what we have to offer as a town.
Of course, hearing of Kinsale's reputation as the gourmet capital of Ireland was something I decided I needed to independently verify. So I met up with Suzanne Burns from Kinsale Food Tours to find out more.
It's obvious from walking around the streets here in Kinsale that it is a food lover's paradise, because on every street corner there's a restaurant. You have so many here.
We're very spoilt in Kinsale. It's like the quality of the food and the standards is amazing. As you can see here, we're actually on the harbour, so you know we are able to get fresh seafood daily. We are very much into local produce, so the local farms like Horizon Farms, you know, an awful lot of the sea food purveyors, like it's just fresh daily here. So, and everyone, you know, tries to do the best they can to support local food as well.
Suzanne, such is the rich tapestry of food culture here in Kinsale that you've even made it your business. Tell us about it.
Yeah, I did. I mean, it seemed like a no-brainer as I'm coming back after many years living abroad and really wanted to have my own job. I was like, you know, wanted to create my own business, and you know, considering my alignment with guiding and my love for food, it seemed like a perfect match.
And as they say, or rather as I'm saying, the proof is in the eating. So myself and Suzanne headed over to the Lemon Leaf Cafe to sample some delicious local cuisine.
Suzanne, you said you were taking me to the Lemon Leaf Cafe. You've taken me to paradise. Look at these dishes.
I know, they're absolutely fantastic. So yeah, we're really lucky that the Lemon Leaf is part of our food tour. It's owned by Tracy Keohane. She started the business in around 2010 in the middle of a deep recession, and she's made this incredible business out of it. So her chef Peter today has made this wonderful array of foods for us. So first we have the combination of, it's like the bacon, black pudding, sausage and egg roll.
It's just so unusual the way it's in puff pastry, you've got the seeds on the top as well, yeah. And then the sausage meat.
Yeah, no, it's an incredible combination.
This is like my dream food.
Mm.
So Suzanne, reluctantly we're going to have to leave this gorgeous dish behind us for the moment, because we've got plenty more to sample too. So what is next?
So next on the menu is it's our seafood main. You can't be in Kinsale without having some of our wonderful seafood. So it's prawn Saint-Jacques in a mustard and cream sauce with mashed potatoes.
The presentation is as pretty as the dish looks.
Yeah, it's absolutely wonderful. I mean, what a scallop shell, it's incredible.
That is so fresh.
It's wonderful.
With potatoes on top.
Oh my God, yeah.
Suzanne, reluctantly, we have to move on to dessert now. That's not a phrase I'm used to saying. So what do we have here?
So we have a miniature pancake on a skewer with fruit. So we have strawberries and blueberries with frosted icing on it. And we also have on the side to go with it to make it even more decadent, we have Nutella, we have a berry compote, and we have maple syrup and a few more fresh strawberries.
I think I'm going to use the knife and fork.
Yeah, me too.
Mm. So light.
Mm.
And
amazing.
It's a simple idea. Well, thank you so much to the ladies here for spoiling us today, and I think it would be rude not to finish all three plates.
Yeah, wouldn't it?
I concur.
Let's go.
With my belly full, it was time to explore Kinsale a little more.
There's a whole host of activities available here in Kinsale, from historical walking tours and water activities to impressive forts and boat trips too, so you'll never be bored in Kinsale.
And if shopping's your thing, there's a fantastic range of top quality shops and boutiques in Kinsale with many unique designs and great gift ideas. Next up for me was the Kinsale Mead Company.
Dennis, I was intrigued to read that mead is the oldest alcoholic drink in the world. Just how old is it and what is it?
So mead is fermented from honey. Okay, so you're using the natural sugars in honey, you're adding water and you're adding a wine yeast in our case, and then you're fermenting the sugars in the honey into alcohol. Mead's origins actually go back several thousand years. We often think of mead being associated with Robin Hood and Friar Tuck and the Vikings and so on, but actually its origins are in China and India several thousand years ago.
So is the whole fermentation process like creating a wine and using the grapes? And if so, is it the same amount of time or is it a quicker process?
It's very similar to wine in many ways. Instead of fermenting grapes or grape juice, you're fermenting honey. And you're also fermenting honey and fruit. The fruit meads in particular, you know, we bottle after about 6 months. Some of the other meads we do, we've aged up to 2.5, 3 years at this stage.
Of course, it would be rude not to try some for myself, so Dennis kindly set up a little tasting session.
We have two styles of mead that we do here. One is just fermented from honey only, that's the golden colours, and the other ones are called melomel mead, so those are fruits and honey fermented together. So we'll start with the wildflower mead, which is the this one here. So this is a medium sweet mead. It'll has the blossom flavours of the honey.
Oh, that's gorgeous. It's very light. Moving on to the wild red mead.
Yeah, so the wild red mead is a melomel mead. So this is actually Wexford blackcurrants, dark sweet cherries, and it's a forest honey.
Oh, it does have that port taste, all right. But much lighter than the port. So next we have the hazy summer mead.
Yeah, so the hazy summer mead is there are six different berries in this. The predominant flavor is strawberry, raspberry, and blackberry.
Oh, that's really good. That's quite a strong taste in comparison to the other two.
It is. It's definitely a lot more fruit here. And this is really one that you could have sort of lightly chilled. You could pour over ice with berries, have it. We sometimes call it our Celtic sangria.
Yes, you can imagine that being a huge hit at a party. And then we're going to finish up with the Atlantic dry mead.
So the Atlantic dry mead was the first mead we made. And this is made with Spanish orange blossom honey.
This is an unusual taste.
Yeah, there's a kind of almost a eucalyptusy, slightly medicinal kick to it.
Thank you so much for teaching
You're
me the
very welcome.
Of mead. Thank you.
My advice when it comes to your 2020 staycation, Kinsale, make a break for it.
Beautiful place and well worth a